Hi everybody, welcome to today's co-video. I'm gonna watch out and make sure my neighbor Oscar doesn't come and attack me. First time outdoors since the last dog licks. This is April 8th, and you know, I'm gonna probably keep things a little upbeat today, but there's still some more work that needs to be done. Number one, I want to give you my temperature again. It's 96.5 Fahrenheit or 35.8 centigrade for today. One of the things I want to point out is that Wuhan City is open for business, and the lockdown is not quite ended, but is slowly ending. That's an important consideration. Especially as we get to where we are. This morning, I'll talk about it later, but this morning I was on a conference call with educators from all over Ohio, and we were talking about how things are going to be in the fall and when we return to normal scheduling and of classes and how it's all going to work out. All right, so one thing that I'll share with you right now is I got an invitation from 23andMe. I have a suspicion what they're looking for, and I think that I've kind of shared that about 2 days ago. And in the co-video, they're looking for susceptibility to COVID-19 and the or at least to the severe, not susceptibility, but to the virulence of it in some people, that there might be a genetic background. And this, of course, is very, very common, that there are genetic markers that help us through all kinds of diseases. That has been going on since we have been living. I mentioned that yesterday was World Health Day, and I want to shout out to all the people who are in healthcare. You are the soldiers at the front line. All of my students, I am wicked proud of you. I mean, I just want to say that are out there doing the work, and doing hard work and doing hard work. And here's a little story about how some nursing staff refused to work at a Detroit hospital, and I have to give my support to the nursing staff. You got to imagine what people are doing right now in healthcare. They're going off to work, and they literally might never see their family again, and their family might not see them again, because they would be put into a hospital and they would not be, visitors are not allowed in the hospitals right now. So, you know, continue our efforts to stay in place, continue our efforts to respect the people in healthcare by not overburdening them right now and trying to keep that down. Speaking of our staying at home, there's some good news today, and some of the modeling data that has come out, and that is every expectation that we have had about this has been lessened and lessened and lessened, and that curve is getting flattened and flattened and flattened, and we are very excited about that. We also have some new projections about how when peaks are going to occur. And I'm telling you that New York City will be very happy, New York in general, but New York City especially, will be very happy to hear that the peak is tomorrow, is projected to be tomorrow. In Massachusetts, the peak is, and if you look at these numbers on this slide here, you know, we're talking about a cumulative 15,000 deaths, which is just a tragedy. Massachusetts is slated to peak in on the 18th of April, and I have to give a quick shout out to Governor DeWine and to Dr. Acton, because Ohio is slated to peak this weekend. And if you look at the size of that curve and the projective deaths, we have really done a fantastic job in Ohio. We have really, really done a fantastic job, and I commend everybody for doing nothing. I commend everybody for staying at home and doing nothing. Oh, the hazards of recording outdoors. All right, and so I'm gonna mention Dr. Fauci, who has said that this is not the time to lit up. This is not the time to lit up. for those of us in Ohio. We can do our victory lap, but we will do it later. Now is the time to stay in there. I also want, as far as doing good things for each other, don't forget to vote. Here in Ohio, we can keep voting. I just got my absentee ballot today, which was a little late, but I got it today, and I'm going to be getting it off in the mail really fast to make sure that it counts. I have to tell you, look at the people in Wisconsin. The people in Wisconsin are awesome. They're awesome in that they went out and they voted in the middle of a lockdown and taking risk for themselves. Apparently, it was that important to them. So those of us in Ohio who can vote by mail, we should contribute to the people from other places who can't do that. We definitely should turn out that vote, and it's an important thing. Finally, as far as doing good for others and being good to each other, I want to tell you that all of us, and my wife works as a speech-language pathologist in pre-K. I work in higher ed, and I will tell you all of the way we are working very hard to make education still go on despite this difficulty that we're all facing. Nobody wanted this, nobody asked for this, but I think a lot of people, and real quick shout out to everybody who has stepped up to the plate and done a great job. I will leave you with this, be the helper. We're all the helpers, hopefully, and we're all doing a great job. Let's keep doing it. And remember to be good to yourself and be good to each other, rather. Be good to yourself and be good to each other. And may you all persist like a lentivirus.